Welcome to Rebuild My Church Again, RMCA Bishop Channel. May God bless and reward you for opening this channel and for your goodwill to listen to this spiritual talk on War with Satan Begun, Win It. Today, you can be happy that God has chosen you for hearing this talk. Therefore, now relax and try to be calm from within for the next few minutes. God is going to bless you. Take a few deep breaths and experience the presence of God inside you. Surrender all your problems and worries for the moment at the foot of the cross. As you listen this talk, God will shower His mercy on you. Pope Francis explained how to live fruitfully and faithfully, and it is in that manner we defeat Satan. The account in Mark's Gospel, chapter 1, verses 12 to 15, emphasizes that the Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert. Jesus was driven to the desert by the Spirit. This is a very important point to be noted, that Jesus was driven to the desert by the Spirit. One can go to the desert by himself as well. Nobody can stop him from going, or can anyone force him to go to the desert. It is his choice and decision. We are not talking about that type of going to the desert. The point here is that I would like to specify is that as Jesus was driven to the desert by the Spirit, we also could be driven to the desert by the Spirit. If we surrender ourselves to God every day, if we pray every day to God for the infilling of the Holy Spirit, I am sure we will be guided by the Holy Spirit in everything we do and everywhere we go. The Pope noted that Jesus remained there 40 days and was tempted by Satan. Here we must understand that in spite of being Son of God, He was not spared of temptation. He also was tested. Many counter thoughts might have crossed his mind. The temptation was very strong when we look at it. The temptation was for food, power, and fame. Jesus is the source of all these. He is a master of all these. And he never desired for it. But during the temptation, Satan was challenging him to prove it. How many times, my dear friend, we accepted silly challenges from others to satisfy our ego? Hereafter, let us stop it. We don't need to prove anything to anybody. God is there who sees everything, and that is enough for us. From today, please keep in mind that we do not need to prove anything to anybody and thus satisfy our ego. Jesus did not fail in the temptation because Jesus knew his identity. That alone was enough for him to defeat Satan. He was on a mission to defeat him. The war begins there. That war ended only on the cross in Calvary. Satan thought that he won, but that was a short-lived satisfaction and celebration. On the third day, Jesus rose again, defeating forever Satan and all his followers. Heaven that was closed by the sin of Adam, with Jesus, it was opened. With his resurrection and ascension, This is what we need to keep in mind. We are also children of God. We are also on a mission. We need to remind ourselves always about our identity. Sense of one's identity will help one to live fruitfully and faithfully. Pope Francis said, "Natural and symbolic reality of the desert is the place where God speaks to the human heart and prayer is a response. But it is also a place of trial and temptation and the duel, the war between Jesus and the devil begins, which will end with the passion and the cross. At that time, Jesus' entire existence will be placed under the sign of the Spirit of God who animated, inspired and guided him." Pope Francis continued that the entire ministry of Christ marked a struggle against the evil one, whether healing from illness, liberating the possessed and forgiving sins. While it may appear that the devil has an upper hand, when Son of God was rejected, captured and condemned to death, in reality, the Pope remarked, death was the last desert to cross, to finally defeat Satan and free us all from his power. The Pope said, "When we read about the desert and the temptations, Christians are reminded that by following in the Lord's footsteps, our lives also are a struggle against the spirit of evil, where the devil can tempt us." He said, "We must be fully aware of the presence of this astute enemy who seeks our eternal condemnation, our failure, and therefore prepare to defend ourselves against him and to combat him." He added that Jesus never dialogued with the devil. Rather, Jesus always sent him away or responded with the word of God. We also should never enter into dialogue with the devil and his temptations. Never have dialogue with those who have aligned with devil and his followers. At the same time, the grace of God assures us that with faith, prayer and penance, we can definitively defeat the enemy. In conclusion, the Pope said, "We are called to walk in God's footsteps, renewing our baptismal promises, renouncing Satan and all his works and all his empty promises." He then encouraged all to call on the maternal intercession of the Virgin Mary, who crushed the head of the serpent. So, my dear friend, war with Satan is just begun. Your life is the desert, the battlefield. Through your own thoughts, temptations will come. Keep a check on them. While doing that, remember about your own identity as children of God. Remember also your commitment to be faithful to him as his child. Never give up in this fight. You will win because God is on your side. Okay? If God touched you through this talk, please feel free to share it with others to increase the number of warriors against Satan. The truth is, if you resist and fight Satan, he will run away. He does not waste his precious time with those who are fighting against him. He will go in search of those who are not aware of this truth and trap them. That's why St. Peter said in his first letter, chapter 5, verse 8, "Be sober and watch. because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, goes about seeking whom he may devour. Be alert, be on watch. This is what Saint Peter is telling. Satan will try to block you now from sending this spiritual message to others, which is against him. God will reward you more for doing good, sharing with others this talk, which is something beautiful and spiritual. That's all for now. Keep maintaining the calmness in your heart, which you are experiencing at this moment. Please place your right hand on your chest. Now make a prayer in your heart for the most urgent blessing that you need. My blessing is for that prayer which you are placing before the Lord now. I pray that God gives you success and prosperity in everything and everywhere. Okay, so here we go. May Almighty God bless you and your family. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. After a few hours, please listen. One more talk if possible. It will bring you more God's blessings. Wish you all good things in life. Yours in the mission of the church, Bishop Franco Mulakim.